Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm very glad to see you today.
I'm sorry.
Atenție dumneavoastră, vă fi prezentat un mic referat de 35 de ani de activitate fără nicio mortalitate în loc stretic în stările critice.
Today I will show you my practice for 35 years in obstetric intensive care.
Sensul principal e activitatea prevenirea situațiilor critice și combaterea lor prin două căi. Asta e lupta cu detresa pulmonară și lupta cu detresa microcirculatorie mitocondrială.
The main target is fight against detress syndrome and
detresa pulmonară și detresa microcirculatorie mitocondrială.
And mitochondrial detress.
Ca bază de la detresa microcirculatorie, începem cu detresa microcirculatorie mitocondrială, a fost luat marcherul hipoxiei tisulare, bioxidul de carbon.
For the first is mitochondrial detress, and the main marker of this is represented by bioxid de carbon. And
la o diferență atrioventriculară, 34-45 în arterială, 47 în venos, în normă trebuie să fie 6.
At the difference at arteriovenous capillary at arterial part between is 34 and 245, and at venous part is 47, and the difference between them must be more than 6.
O altă parte când se mărește bioxidul de carbon este detresa pulmonară.
When we have increased parts of bioxid de carbon, it's represented in respiratory distress.
Cu excluderea detresei respiratorii pulmonare, începem activitatea cu combaterea detresei microcirculatorii mitocondriale.
If we exclude respiratory distress, we must support our mitochondria, and it must be problem in this mitochondrial distress.
Aceasta înseamnă că noi la toate stările critice terminal, numai în obstetrică, dar și în toate cele, activăm pe refacerea macrocirculației în microcirculație.
And
la toate stările critice terminale, refacem macrocirculație în microcirculație.
In all critical state, we must reform the microcirculation state.
Asta înseamnă că la când activează doar macrocirculația, sistemul ăsta toată nu lucrează. Sângele se duce prin albă șunt direct.
In this case, we have stopped microcirculation and all blood will flow from anastomosis arteriovenous.
Funcția noastră era să deschidem capilarul metabolic.
Our function is to liberate metabolic capillary.
Și să arestăm șuntul arteriovenos.
And to arrest arteriovenous shunt.
Asta înseamnă că noi activăm pe trei căi. Prima, ameliorăm funcția de pompă a inimii, funcția de pompă a inimii.
That means that we must make a influence free fat. We see on all of the monitors.
Presiunea capilară rezistență în luăm de presiunea oculară la pacientul nou cu glaucom.
The pressure in capillary resistant we find by the pressure in eye.
Asta pentru un aspect clinic în toate nivelurile de asistență medicală. Asta e o determinare pentru toate spitalurile, toate accesibile pentru toate spitalurile.
It's accessible for all hospitals.
Presiunea arterială medie 90, rezistența 20, presiunea sistemică spre mea 70.
The medium pressure is 90, the pressure in resistant capillary is 20, and the difference between them is 70.
Ceea ce înseamnă că noi trebuie să menținem presiunea sistemică 70.
This all show us that we must maintain the pressure in capillary by 70 mm hydrargyl.
Prin modularea farmacologică la nivelele respective de șunturi, receptori și așa mai departe.
By pharmacology modulation at the microcircuit, at the capillary, metabolic capillary, at the shunt of arteriovenous capillary.
La așa o rezistență sistemică, dioxidul de carbon se duce din depo și aici sigur că vin oxigen.
At this pressure of 70 mm of hydradium, we have the exchange between mitochondrial and metabolic capillary, and we will show that bioxid decarbon goes to the capillary and oxygen returns to
the mitochondria. În așa mod, prin sistemul de dirijare, recrutare microcirculatorie, noi eliberăm dioxidul de carbon și aducem.
In this way, we will liberate, we will make mitochondrial recruitment by liberation mitochondria from bioxid to carbon and approve this with oxygen.
Is that calcium, by the way, above the mitochondria?
Asta e celula, înăuntru celulei
mitochondriei.
Calcium? Da. Ca să intri în mitochondria, faci contact cu mediul
intracelular
prin ionii de calcium uniporter.
It's a uniporter, calcium uniporter that makes this exchange of gases.
O, a doilea, asta noi am spus când avem cu MMMBS-ul.
This is characteristic for multi-organic
mitochondrial distress.
To mitochondrial microcirculatory distress syndrome.
Toată sistema asta. Când avem ARDS-ul, distresa pulmonară.
When we have respiratory distress pulmonary, when also we have increased level of bioxid to carbon, when we make microcirculatory recruitment at this level,
practică multi-organ suportiv.
We use multi-organic support therapy.
Care include respirație, regimul de respirație artificială.
That include artificial respiratory mood.
A doilea, toate tehnologiile de renale.
All renal technologies like dialysis.
Și metodele de purificare extracorporală.
And extracorporal purification method of
plasmapheresis.
Plasmapheresis.
Plasmasorption.
Plasmasorption.
Hemosorption.
Hemosorption.
ECMO, extracorporal, hemoxygenare extracorporală.
And extracorporal hemoxygenation.
Care noi la început am început să o facem prin dializatorul, pentru un dializator urinar.
When we, at first time, we used to, we use and from third part enter pressure. And from the other side, exit blood, oxygenation blood. And the and from another side to exit to ultrafiltrate.
Asta a fost prototipul la ECMO. În condițiile de spital, că facem mașină, dar care e venus.
It was a prototype that was used in our hospital, like a prototype of hemoxygenation, extracorporeal hemoxygenation.
Înainte să zice, luptăm pentru viața pacientului până la ultima presuflare.
In the past, we said that we must fight for life, for the life of our patients upon
for the last
respiration.
Pe urmă au apărut respiratoarele, ventilatoarele și noi am trecut la luptăm pentru viața pacientului până la ultima bătaie inimii.
After that, in our hospitals appears respiratory devices, and after that, we used to say that we must fight for our patient's life
contraction, cardiac.
Nowadays with this extracorporeal hemoxygenation, we don't know what to say because patients is like dead patient, but he is in conscience.
Prototipul la ECMO în Rusia o aplicat plămânii de câini extracorporal la om.
Like a prototype of extracorporeal hemoxygenation, Russia used the lung of dogs.
Oh, that's interesting.
It was 50 years ago.
Oh, yeah, 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 yeah.
But now we...
And radio use the machine.
Yeah, we...
În principiu, tehnologiile este la toate patologiile obstacale, de ce origine ar fi ele, HELP, șocuri, sepsisuri, tromboboliști și așa mai departe, nu... s-au terminat cu succes, împreună, s-au terminat cu succes.
You know states like HELLP syndrome, like distress respiratory syndrome, like mitochondrial distress syndrome, we used to...
Așa, astfel, descentralizare, deșocare.
We use decentralization, deșocked.
Detoxifierea și analgezierea în strategia medicului recrutării microcirculatorii mitocondriale.
Detoxification of mitochondrial microcirculatory.
Sprijinată de terapie multiorganică.
Supported by multiorganic support therapy.
Și combinată cu tratamentul antibacterial antiviral.
And combined by antibacterial and antiviral treatment.
Și chirurgie, corecție chirurgicală.
And surgical correction.
Combate distresa microcirculatorii mitocondriale.
Mitochondrial respiratory distress syndrome.
Colapsul mitocondrial.
Also mitochondrial collapse.
Și deinstalează MOTS-ul.
And we remove mood syndrome.
Concluziile, deciziile.
Conclusions.
Yeah. Creștere markerului hipoxiei tisulare de dioxid de carbon la diferența având spațiu tisular mai mare decât 6.
The increased of increased marker of bioxid de carbon more than 6 mm hydrator.
La excluderea distresei pulmonare.
When we exclude distress syndrome, respiratory distress syndrome,
confirm syndrome of distress in circulatory mitochondrial.
In this way, we confirm mitochondrial distress syndrome.
Colapsul mitochondrial.
Or mitochondrial collapse.
Care demonstrează încetinirea staza propulsării dioxidului de carbon.
That demonstrates. That demonstrates stays or or decrease of circulatory
propulsare de oxid și gaz de stres.
The propulsion of bioxide de carbon.
Din periferie spre centru.
By the peripheral part to the center part.
Și cumularea lui datorită afectării.
And accumulation.
Datorită afectării presiunii sistemului de perfuzie.
And accumulation because it's altered systemic perfusion pressure.
Care conjugă echilibrul macrocirculației și microcirculației.
That conjugates equilibrium between microcirculation and macrocirculation.
Recrutarea microcirculatorii mitocondriale se reface prin modelarea presiunii de sisteme.
Microcirculatory mitochondrial recruitment.
Se reface prin modelare.
It's made by modeling.
Care descentralizează macrocirculația.
But modeling decentralizations of macrocirculation.
Și beneficiază microcirculație în spațiu metabolic.
And it will take, it will show benefits on microcirculatory system. Or
capilar celulă.
At the level of cell capillary.
Arestează anastomozul arteriovenos direct.
Arrest this shunt between arteria and vena.
Și reface microcirculație prin capilarul metabolic.
And we have liberate microcirculatory part.
Astfel remodelează rata metabolică energetică celulei.
In this case, we will have remodulating part in mitochondrial level of energy.
Recrutarea microcirculatorii mitocondriale drenează în macrocirculație.
Microcirculatory mitochondrial recruitment will
drain în macrocirculație deșeurile din sesucul.
Drain the waste in microcirculation.
Primește toxemie translocată.
And we will have translocated toxemia.
Care confirmă că a fost hipoxia tosulară.
It will confirm that we have in past tisular hipoxia.
Iar reducându-se marcherul dioxidului de carbon la diferență, prin reducerea marcherului dioxidului de carbon la diferență normală AV nu mai mare de 6.
And in this case, we decreased marker of hypoxia not more than 6.
Absența căderii markerului hipoxiei tisulare dioxid de carbon la diferența AV după recrutare.
In absence of decreased of this marker after recruitment,
respinge necrozul apoptozei.
We can detect necrosis that it wasn't necrosis.
Energia celulară.
And level of energy in the cell.
Dovedește remodelarea metabolică.
Approved remodeling.
Remodelare metabolică.
Approved metabolic remodulation.
Mitocondrială.
Metabolic mitocondrial.
Odată cu reducerea mitocondriilor hipoenergice.
With decreased hipo or energic mitochondria.
Prin clearance celulei lizosomale mitofagice.
By the clearance. In this case, we will demonstrate the presence of eugergic mitochondria.
Cu normalizarea uniportului calciu mitocondrial.
with normalization of this uniporter of calcium.
Care productiv inactivează formele toxice ale azotului și oxigenului.
That detoxified toxic forms of oxygen and nitrogen.
Presiunea sistemică poate fi modelată prin modificarea pompii cardiace.
Systemic pressure of perfusion can be modeling by
modificarea pompii cardiace.
By changing a pump function.
Volumul efectiv total de sânge.
Blood volume.
Și presiunea capilară, rezistenția capilarului.
And pressure in resistant capillary.
Deinstalarea morțului poate fi obținută prin asociația reclutării microcondriale cu terapia multiorganică de
Dezinstallation of
multiple organ
of MUT syndrome.
Poate fi obținut prin asociere recrutării mitocondriale.
By the associations of recruitment, mitochondrial recruitment.
Terapie de suport multiplu.
Multiple organ therapy, support therapy.
Astfel numit.
It will be all together.
Extracorporeal.
It will be all together like a part of extracorporeal.
Managementul strategic descris prezintă esența recrutării microcirculatării mitocondriale.
Strategic management will be described like
unde lângă bolna vizual noi vedem fără multe analize, unde vizual vedem refacerea benefică microcirculatorului mitocondrială.
We will see at the patient with the microcirculatory mitochondrial recruitment, warming of the skin, spots when we press at fingernail spot, the therapia.
Deși pe parcursul activității de 35 de ani am înregistrat toate cazurile critice în obstetrică.
For 35 years we win all emergent care in obstetrics.
Nu avem niciun deces matern.
We don't have any dead in any family tests.
Recunosc că este încă distanțiat terapie perfectă.
We know that is a very distant perfect therapy.
Pentru a atinge regresul mai favorabil la recrutare al depresiei.
To achieve this regress of this recruitment of this mitochondrial recruitment.
Deoarece de metodele suntem foarte departe.
Because we don't have all that we need to produce this recruitment better.
Suntem foarte departe. Mulțumesc foarte mult.
Thank you for your attention.
În cer iertare că m-am prezentat media, multe slide-uri.
Nicio
problemă.
Nicio problemă.
Eu prefer să vorbesc cu auditoria liber, dar am ea problemele de limbă, ei s-au odihnit cu mine.
I like to speak with audience, but with my problem with language, all audience, I feel more free.
Well, now this has been a very dramatic presentation, but very valuable. I'll tell you why it is valuable, very important. But first, this has been a torture for the poor little girl. Now, you told me that, you know, it would take 10 minutes and it took 5 hours. So, I mean, the 5 hours torture for the poor little girl. And so now, this has been very dramatic, you know. But in the end, you know, I mean, it has been worth it. So now my question, in a very quick evaluation, probably the comprehension of the whole thing might be missed a little here, but now this is very, very important. We can hardly see any similar, never identical, but any similar studies like this. The continuation of this could be also enormous and unbelievably useful. I'm sure I will be asking him that. I haven't seen the details of this article, but I was really amazed because the conditions in Moldova, in terms of research facilities and capabilities, is almost zero. Nothing. You know, you cannot make something like this up. You know, you cannot just achieve something like this in Moldova, in today's Moldova. It is totally zero. You know, I mean, research, I mean, something like this, something like this. It is just admirable. Now, I will be asking him the question for the probably the possible continuation of this, because the continuation is important. In human cell, there are two most sensitive and delicate organelles, and the others are okay, tolerable and tolerant, and also durable, if not tolerant. But okay. Now, there, in the schema, he showed perfectly that mitochondria. There are two delicate organelles in very good.
Sorry, it's an EX code for me.
Okay, now when we have respiratory distress syndrome, now we automatically have a crippled circulation. When we have the circulation crippled, the delicate human cells has two very, very far more delicate organelles. One is mitochondria and the other is Golgi apparatus. So they just go destroyed, almost. I mean, Golgi would go almost destroyed, and mitochondria, well, you know, it can survive, but even if it is survived now, then after that, you know, it is very difficult to make. He calls it recruitment. So it can be, but it won't be as good as before. The others, lysosomes and ribosomes and endoplasmic reticulum also. I mean, lysosomes and ribosomes, they are very tolerant. They can survive, and endoplasmic reticulum is an organelle which does not care. It has its own life tools and mechanisms, and I mean, even if there is a great deal of, I mean, even if there is a shock, a circulatory shock, anything, it can survive, but only up to a certain moment, because the body dies. You know, I mean, when the circulatory shock gets established fully, then the body dies anyway. So everything goes away, everything dies. But now, mitochondria. Is so delicate, you know. He's now Professor Vasiliev is now he's been explaining us how to deal with this. You know, I haven't seen any similar article anything similar to this. This is unique. This is amazing. Now, my question to him is that, okay, now the recruitment of mitochondria, that's a very nice description. That can be done, I'm sure. I'm not familiar with that on that front. But I want to ask him, apart from the life support, I mean, the mechanical support for the reestablishment of the circulation, what does he have any plan to do, or any kind of research or work in this on this line, in regard to the reestablishment of the functionality of mitochondria on the cellular level, or any continuing researcher, because that's important.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, sure.
Thank you for question.
Sure.
The researches had been made in Russian, in Ukrainian,
yeah,
and Middle Asia.
Yeah. Oh. Already. Yeah.
And
maybe some in Russia.
Very good. Very good.
The work is very perspective with the progress,
yeah,
future, and we need to work on this.
Yeah, because now the continuation is very, very important. You know, I mean, this is very important, and without the future continuation of this, it would just stay there. You know, I mean, it should. Yeah.
That's why we have rooms.
Absolutely.
Private. Yes. Hospital.
That's the point. Yes, you are right. You are right. Of course, because I know that the facilities and availabilities are there. As I said, almost zero, nothing. Sure.
But my father combined everything into.
Sure. Now in Groningen, in the North Netherlands, I think there is a group. There is a group working not on the same theme, but within the same vicinity. I'll get a hold of them and I'll see. Now at this moment, I don't know what they are doing now. If they are doing anything related to the same field, same subject. If they are still working on the same subject, I'll put them in touch with Professor Vasiliev. Yeah, as bombs under the under our, I mean, he's an executive, so I mean, if there's something to relate to, that will be immediate, because now this is a very, very big possession now, scientifically, you know, for him. So it should go on. The ones in Russia, the ones who have been done or completed or whatever. Was he involved?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Very good. Very good. I congratulate you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
I just wanted to point out that there's another, actually, thank you. Pues en orden.
Each of problem. I just wanted to point out, of course, congratulating you all three for the efforts there in for such a great presentation. Thank you. I just wanted to point out that there's this, actually Dr. Osorio is very aware of Dr. Aubrey de Grey, who is running the SENSE Research Foundation, which is based in California. And they have this program called MitoSENSE, which is again focused on cellular senescence. And I've had a word with some of the people involved in the project. Maybe it would be an excellent opportunity for you to go ahead and explore this from the mitochondrial sense of it all. In precisely in the respiratory aspect at a cellular level, where they are actually focusing on providing I would say a solution on how to sustain the energy production through the respiratory process. Perhaps this could be something where you could sort of hook up, I don't know if that's the word, but and explore this further. And perhaps this exchange in the cellular respiration would be something to tackle. And I don't know if having to do with extra glucose input could also provide more time for the cell to survive, even in hypoxia scenarios.
Sure.
So, you know, with all due respect and honor, it would be my honor to put you in touch with these guys.
Do you have anything to say?
Doctor,
no,
sorry?
Just thinking, but later.
Are you sure?
Later.
He's still processing the idea.
Yes, that's right. That's right. Yeah. So, no problem.
Just my...
No problem.
Nietzsche problem.
Nietzsche problem.
Nietzsche problem. Nietzsche
problem. That's in Moldovan language, Nietzsche problem.
No problem.
No problem, yeah. Okay. Now, any other questions? Any other... Yeah, okay. Yeah. Then I think you conclude.
Thank you very much.
So,